In today's video, we'll take a look at how you can quickly and easily remove moving objects from your video clips in Final Cut Pro using the FCPX Removal plugin from Pixel Film Studios. Decide what stays and what goes and make unwanted moving objects disappear from your video. Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge and welcome back to my channel. Today, we'll be taking a look at the FCPX Removal plugin from Pixel Film Studios. What this plugin does is analyze your clip, detects moving objects, and deletes them from your clip, revealing the background. Let's jump into Final Cut Pro and take a look at what we can do with this plugin. Before we get started, one thing to keep in mind is in order for this plugin to work on your clip, the video has to be perfectly still. There can't be any camera movement in your clip at all. Let's start off with a simple example. For our first clip, let's use FCPX Removal to remove this hot air balloon floating across the sky. After installing the FCPX Removal plugin, open the Effects browser and scroll down to the FCPX Removal category. Grab this effect and drag and drop it over your clip. With your clip selected, in the inspector, click the Analyze button to open it up in its own window. At the top of the sidebar, from the drop-down menu, select Pixel Analysis. Just like that, the hot air balloon is gone. At the bottom of the sidebar, click Analyze Clip to analyze your clip. And once it's done, click Finish to export the data to your timeline. It's that simple. But in all fairness, that was a very simple clip. Let's try it on something a bit harder. In our next clip, let's use the FCPX Removal to remove all the traffic off this freeway, but leave the movement in the trees and on the side of the road untouched. By default, when you apply this plugin to your clip, it analyzes and removes all the dynamic parts. To omit certain items from this plugin, we have to make another copy of the clip and mask out the parts we want left in. Hold down the Option key and drag up on your clip to make a copy. Make sure the top clip is selected and press V to disable it for now. Grab the FCPX Removal effect, apply it to your bottom clip, and in the inspector, click the Analyze button. Once again, from the drop-down menu, select Pixel Analysis. As you can see in the viewer, it doesn't quite remove all the cars, and there's a few artifacts left on screen. This is where you can use the threshold slider to fine-tune your clip. Drag the adjustment slider to either side until the dynamic objects in your clip are mostly gone. You might not be able to completely remove them, but try and get as close as possible. Click Analyze Clip. Once a plugin analyzes your clip, any visible parts or artifacts should be gone. If there's still some left behind, you can fine-tune your threshold slider and reanalyze your clip. Our demo clip looks good, so let's click the Finish button to export data to our timeline. Next, select the top clip and press V to re-enable it. In the Effects browser, select the Masks category and apply the Draw Mask to your clip. Add control points to outline the freeway. Go back to the inspector and select Invert Mask. We'll let this clip render out, and here's your finished result. In this next clip, let's use the FCPX Removal to remove all the cars from this intersection except for one, maybe the green car. First, make a copy of your clip, layer it above your timeline, and press V to disable it. Apply the FCPX Removal effect to your bottom clip, and in the inspector, click the Analyze button. Select Pixel Analysis, and adjust the threshold slider until most, if not all, the cars in this clip disappear. Analyze your clip, and click Finish to export the data to your timeline. Re-enable your top clip, and once again, add the Draw Mask effect. Place your playhead where the car is clearly visible, zoom in on your viewer, and add control points to outline the car. Make sure to include the shadow. You can also play with a feather slider to soften the edges of the mask. Add keyframes to control points and all the transform parameters. Move your playhead ahead a few frames and adjust the position and control points of your mask. Keep doing this until the car is out of the frame. Select your top clip in the timeline and press Ctrl V to show video animation. Move your playhead back to the first keyframe and from there, go back through a clip adjusting the mask position. Let the clip render out, and here's what we have. Let's take a look at one more example, and this time, instead of using pixel analysis, use the temporal mask. This is great for clips where the moving subject remains in the same part of the frame for most of the clip, and only moves for a brief amount of time, revealing the background. We'll use this to remove one of the dancers from our next clip. Copy your clip, layer it above your original, and press V to disable it. Apply FCPX removal to your bottom clip, and in the inspector, click the Analyze button. What we need to do first is remove both dancers so we have a clean plate of the background. Make sure temporal masking is selected, and click and drag out a selection over the background. Repeat this to isolate other parts of the background, making sure not to overlap our subjects. Skim ahead in the timeline to where the dancers move, and add another layer to the mask. Do this as many times as necessary until the entire background is masked off. You can preview your image to make sure no parts are missed by switching to pixel analysis from the drop-down menu. Once your entire background is covered, analyze your clip and click Finish to export the data to your timeline. Re-enable your top clip, and once again, add the draw mask effect. Add control points to outline the dancer you want to leave in the video. Add keyframes to your control points and the transform parameters, and go through your clip, adjusting the mask with the subject. Once you're done, render out your clip, and just like that, we removed one of the two dancers in the video clip. Nice and simple. The FCPX Removal plugin from Pixel Film Studios is just one of many awesome plugins that lets us do things in Final Cut Pro that were simply impossible before. If this is something you might be interested in when checking out, make sure to use the coupon code SEARCHPIXEL for 30% off your first purchase, limited to the first 500 downloads. A huge thank you to Pixel Film Studios for sponsoring this video and making effects like this possible in Final Cut Pro. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.